Hi, I'm Dustin Mercer, and I'm the inventor of TrueTester, this little thing right here. And I'm going to show you everything I know about my little invention, how to use it, some exciting applications, the game, and what I know about applied kinesiology. So let's get started. You want the ring right here, you know, started in the middle, and simply initially just squeeze TrueTester as hard as you can to get comfortable with it. It's not always going to slide all that far, depending on how strong you are. If you're very strong and it closes all the way, which I don't think I can do, just switch to another hand. Also use two fingers on top to squeeze it closed. The most important thing to remember is that you want to use the exact same finger position each time, because if you test it once with this sort of, with the strength of one finger, and then test it again with two fingers, you're getting a whole different response. You want to determine how your body reacts under exact same conditions. So the first thing we're going to do is take a simple test. You have the ring above here, and we're just going to smile and say the word yes, because we're going to create a what's known as a positive thought energy field. So I'll just smile and say yes, yes. That's going to give me ostensibly my highest energy reading. Then we're going to create a negative thought field and say no and frown, no. And you can see that this tube will not extend as far as it did before with the yes. The average differential in strength between a positive energy field and a negative one, between a yes and a no, is only an average of 17%. That means some people are going to have a differential of 20%, a big differential. Others will have a differential of only 10. Because we're only squeezing about an inch or so here, a 17% differential, it's only going to be, you know, sometimes an eighth of an inch. The people have written to me and said, it doesn't work. there's no difference between the readings. And they get a reading, say, something like this, and the next reading would be something like that. Now, because it's not touching, that means that the second reading, you know, was showing a no or a weaker response. But because it seems so close, they think they're getting the same response, when indeed they're not. They're, like I said, visually, it's not that, you can't really tell. If you didn't have this ring there, you'd really be confused. So, because you'd have nothing, you know, a strong visual or physical indication. When we say something we know is true, our body stays strong. So when I say something I know is true, like my name is Dusty, and I squeeze, my name is Dusty. That's my maximum strength reading. When I say something false, like my name is Santa Claus, and I squeeze again, my name is Santa Claus. I cannot squeeze with maximum strength as hard as I went before. You can also test things, you can use the body to test things that you consciously do not know are true or false. Of course, one of the first things I did to test using this highly sophisticated device and highly spiritual applied kinesiology procedure, first thing I did was to test to see whether or not a girl I liked was cheating on me, if she was a little more involved with the guy she was seeing than she said she was. She said, we are not intimate, we do not spend nights together or anything like that. But so, I believed her. So I tested this woman is sleeping with Mr. X, and I tested. So that's interesting. I tested she is not sleeping with Mr. X. I thought, TrueTester says she's sleeping with Mr. X. So I called her up, And actually, even before I called her up, I used True Tester to see if she was home, just because I was testing everything. I said, my little invention here says you're sleeping with Gary. And she said, yeah, I am, as a matter of fact. She said, that's amazing. And she said, where can I get one of those things? You know, the people I want to test. So it was definitely a double-edged sword. It's like, all right, this thing really works. It's like, but damn it. So, once again, it bypassed my wishful thinking, truly wishful thinking, and my body knew the truth at a subverbal level, unfortunately. So, if you ask questions about yourself, say, you think you want to be a stockbroker. Sounds good, you make more money. Whatever it might be, if you're offered a job as a stockbroker, and you think you want to be a stockbroker, but deep, deep down, your subconscious, just at the subconscious level, more than you don't want to be a stockbroker, it's not in your greatest and highest good. And that's a great phrase to use when testing, especially when testing yourself. I can test myself. I would say something like, it is in my greatest and highest good to become a stockbroker. And I'd press, and then I'd say it's not in my greatest and highest good to become a stockbroker. Apparently not. It is in my greatest and highest good to become a stockbroker. So because True Tester and applied kinesiology and your subconscious mind have very clear, non-thinking, non-sort of rationally interpretive, ego-driven, me ways of looking at life and the world, it says, yes, no, and that's the end of that. Like I said, wishful thinking, wishing, hoping that you could become a stockbroker if you ask the question properly. If it's not in your greatest, highest good, your subconscious mind will say, no. But all that money and cars, whatever. Subconscious mind doesn't really care. For instance, I love corn, and if I were to hold, and I don't get, you know, physically ill when I eat popcorn or eat corn, I kind of like it, but I was testing all sorts of things, and I test corn, then I test, I could say corn is good for me, and I'll say corn is not good for me, and there goes the ring. Why, I don't know. Have I stopped eating corn? No. But I guess which leads us to another issue. According to Dr. David Hawkins and John Diamond and many others, everything in so many words has its own energetic signature. I guess you could say everything is either good or bad for us. And this works on an individual basis. If corn is not bad for somebody else, they will stay strong with corn. So if you have a particular allergy, you will go weak when perhaps you hold a cat and stay strong when the cat's not there. If you're allergic to cats or sulfates, whatever it might be. Conversely, if you test the cat for something else, if you say, you know, this cat's name is, you know, Sparkles, and his name is Sparkles, it'll say yes when you say his name is Sparkles, and it'll say no when his name is Not sparkles. Because the thought energy of what you're is what you're testing. The thought energy is inherently true. The thought energy is inherently false. Or just the presence of the particular thing for you is good or bad. There are another great thing that True Tester is good for are the thousands and thousands of essences out there that you can find at the health food store or what have you. There are thousands of them. How do you know which one's good for you? Well, as with anything, you could simply hold it, think about it. A lot of times in kinesiology, a popular procedure is to hold it to your chest. For some foods or vitamins, if you have them right there, you can place them under your tongue. You can just, like I said, you can just think about particular essences and so on. And you can say that, you know, this flower extract, flower essence is good for me. And you can say it's not good for me. You can judge it that way. Or you can simply hold it and then test and then put it down and test again. And if you're stronger when you're not holding it, it's not an essence that's, it's probably not going to hurt you, but you can ask whether or not it will hurt you, or in so many words. But if you're stronger when you're when you hold it, it's good for you. David Hawkins did an interesting test, again, I guess dealing with the notion that the application of applied kinesiology bypasses wishful thinking. Everyone knows, heaven help if you're a smoker, because everyone knows it's bad for you. Everyone knows smoking cigarettes is bad for you. So, but David Hawkins did an interesting test. And we will do something similar right now. I'm just going to say commercial tobacco, commercial tobacco. Then he did a test with 100% organic tobacco that was not exposed to pesticides and so on and so forth. It was just a pure plant. And so I will just create the thought field of pure organic tobacco. I could hold some pure organic tobacco, so I'll just say pure organic tobacco, and there goes the ring. Commercial tobacco, organic tobacco. It doesn't make you strong. What we are exploring is the notion that it keeps you strong. You're naturally strong in your natural state. So what you do to repolarize yourself properly, you think of someone that you love, or just think of a very positive individual. You can think of Abraham Lincoln, Jesus Christ. You smile and you pound the thymus gland right here while you also laugh. So you might not want to do this in the supermarket if you're testing organic bananas or whatever it might be. But if you do it quickly, maybe no one will notice. But all you do is you go three times, you go, ha, 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 or five times or whatever it is. And amazingly, you will be in the proper energetic configuration. You always want to test if you're reversed beforehand. I didn't know about this reversal process for a good 6-7 months when I was first using applied kinesiology. And there were some issues, there were some problems, and even when I was testing things I knew to be true, knew to be positive, I was getting this negative answer, and thought, oh my God, this thing doesn't work. Well, it works, but I just happened to be reversed. So the first thing you do, like I said, is test whether or not you're reversed, and then you're ready to go. When I first invented True Tester, my father said, "What in the hell, what's this good for?" He was in town, and we were at the Holiday Inn, and we were having breakfast, and I'll say, "I'll show you." It's not of high practical importance, but it just demonstrates how the body knows things at a subverbal level of which the mind has no clue, and furthermore, believes it's absolutely ridiculous and virtually impossible to know. So we had a waitress, and I asked, I said, "This, you know, our waitress is married," and I honestly forget the answer I got, and I said, "Our waitress is not married." I believe I got the response that she was married. And then I said if she had children or not. I said she does have children. And then she does not have children. And I got a response. And so when she came to the table, I said, "I hope you don't think I'm being intrusive or odd. But I said, my little device here says that you're married and that you have children." And she said, "I do. Yes, I do." I could have determined how many kids and how old and so on and so forth. I've done it many, many times. Which brings us to another good point. When you are using True Tester in the so-called questions you are asking, do not ask a question. Do not say, "Does she have children?" Because True Tester is not going to suddenly go, "Yeah, she has children." You are creating a thought field that is either true or not. My first exposure to applied kinesiology was a visit to my psychologist. I honestly can't remember the specific problem. And for all intents and purposes, at this point, it wasn't necessary that even he or I was aware of the problem. He had me extend my arm in the typical applied kinesiology form, because this hadn't been invented yet, and he had me state, "I am ready to be rid of my problem." And I held out my arm, and my arm just went straight down. I got weak. He had me say, "I'm not ready to be rid of my problem," and I stayed strong, which meant that deep down, bypassing my wishful thinking, what you would think I'd be consciously aware of, I did not want to be rid of my problem. Deep down, subconsciously, apparently, I liked my problem. We could pretty easy to speculate or theorize that even though you consciously want to be rid of your problems, guess what? They're also very familiar. They give us a reason to complain and feel important. Oh, you wouldn't believe the things that I go through. They generate sympathy. And as much as we hate them, a lot of times, you know, we die for our problems, whether it's smoking, drinking. We don't want to give them up. Sometimes it's very important and very obvious we don't want to give them up. But it's interesting, my mind immediately said, "How dare you access my thoughts without my permission?" And a split second later, I thought, that's pretty cool. you can instantly access how I truly, truly think about things. And what an important thing for a psychiatrist or psychologist to know about his patient as to whether or not they really want to get better. And I remember thinking, you know, of course I want to get rid of my problem. That's why I'm here. I've gone to, you know, all the trouble and expense of visiting you and wanting to talk with you. But deep down, To put it nicely, even though we're sort of a gutter or crap, we all like our own crap. Another thing that's good to do, fun to do, and will really help you understand and appreciate True Tester. I made it very small, light, portable, and sturdy. So you can take it with you anywhere you want. It'll just fit right into your pocket. And it's real fun to use it in so-called real-life situations, because you'll get some of the most, I think some of your more interesting results that way. For instance, I was at the Barnes & Noble. I was starting my company, True Tester LLC. I wanted a book on how to create an LLC. I found the book right there. I left Barnes & Noble. Why, I don't know. Maybe I needed to get some cash, get some lunch, something like that. I came back 30, 40 minutes later, went right back to where the book was, and it was gone. It's like, what the heck? You know, what are the chances that someone in the last half hour would come buy that very same book? And it was the only one there. So I happened to have my True Tester with me. I assumed the thing was gone, but I looked and looked and looked and looked. And I also knew it wasn't there. I knew it wasn't there. So I used True Tester, and I'll can do the same thing now in retrospect. The book was there, and then I tested, the book is not there, and it kept on saying, this thing kept on saying, it's there, so I kept on looking and looking and looking. It wasn't there. I'm telling you, I was there for 45 minutes, really hoping that this thing worked, because it was adamant. That's another thing, you get a big differential. Sometimes they'll be bigger than others, you know, the space between the ring and the end there. You can feel the difference in your own personal strength. It means it's definitely true. There was a big differential. So I looked and looked and looked, and I was cursing. 45 minutes later, in the wrong section, I just happened to, you know, I left and looked in a whole different section for something else. There it was, the book I'd been looking for. And I was like, this thing really, really works. I went down to Florida to see my parents. And I, again, I just invented this and wanted to show it off. I was perfecting my skills, as it were. And I was testing a little bit of everything. And I tested something I also knew absolutely was true, that my sister Laura was arriving that afternoon. So I just said, you know, Laura's arriving, and Laura's not arriving. And it came up that she wasn't arriving. Typically, you don't want to test the future, because truly, the future is not predictable in so many words. Although it can be. I digress, and hopefully I'll get back to the future here in a second. At any rate, said that she wasn't coming. 15 minutes later, the phone rings, and my dad calls, and we talk and talk, and he says, oh, by the way, Laura's not coming. She's snowed in Denver. So it's like, once again, it's like, that's incredible. I knew she was coming. I mean, it wasn't a maybe, she was coming. In the world of thought energy, of pure energy, my body knew at a subverbal level beyond all conscious reasoning that she wasn't coming. And it was reading the present situation. In so many words, it wasn't, reading the future. In essence, it was, but because she was presently snowed in Denver and had called and said that she wasn't coming, True Tester was reading the present, as it were. Now, in terms of reading the future, I used this, of course, when I first made it, to predict the future. And I absolutely, positively, once again, knew that it couldn't work. Didn't believe it could work. I used it to make stock picks. I would just say, you know, Apple computers going up 1 point tomorrow, is going up 2 points, half a point, it'll be going up 10 points. I was virtually 100% accurate, and I made money. I made a lot of money. And I used it to predict the future on, that's about all. The first time I used it to predict football games, I picked 12 out of 12 winners, far, far beyond the realm of chance. Not only that, I remember telling my dad about the predictions during halftime, and I said, yeah, you even predict the New York Giants to win. He said, well, your invention is really not worth anything, because the Giants are the worst team in football. They've lost their last six. Giants won. I would just say Steelers, then I'd say Raiders. One could say that I was just reading the general level of energy, conscious awareness of power, which is much more powerful, say, than force, which can be diminished and eventually peters out, whereas power is sort of infinite. As soon as I got down into the level of greed and me, it just stopped working altogether. First-time users, myself included, who don't believe this can work, have had great success, as you probably will too. Unless you start off thinking very greedily, oh man, I'm going to make so much money using this. I gave it to a little 11-year-old friend of mine. He determined the day, month, and year of a total stranger's birthday. If you want to do that, say you have a rough idea of the person's year of birth, you say it was between 1950 and 1960, you'll get a yes. Then you'll cut it down to it was between 50 and 55, including 55, and you'll get a yes or no. If it was 55 to 60, get a yes or a no. To get the month, you say it was in the first 6 months, you test. It was in the second 6 months of the year, you test, you get a yes, and then you go down to 3 months, to 1 month, and you do the same thing with the month. It was in the first 15 days, it was the last 15 days, and you go week to week to week. And that's how we did it. And I've had other people also determine my birthday who had no idea. There's a great temptation to overuse TrueTester when you first get it, especially if you have start having all these miraculous fun results. One thing I caution you against is using it too much. Not only will your hand get tired, I could not move my hand for days after just the first day of using this, because I used it so much. I thought this was another neat test, a used car test. First time I used it for my car, I said, how did I test? I said that, I know, I tested things. I said so many words, you know, the air conditioning is good, the air conditioning is bad, the brakes are good, the brakes are bad. And I didn't really get real strong yeses and nos. And it turns out I bought the car, and everything was wrong with it, and this stupid thing didn't work at all. And I thought, well, that's crazy, because I've used it thousands of times, and it's worked great. The problem was I was making the wrong statements. Brakes aren't good or bad unless they're possessed by Satan. They're just steel. So, coincidentally and fortuitously enough, a friend of mine, we were emailing back and forth, and she said she was buying a used car. I said, oh, this is great. I can use it once more to test a used car before she buys it to see what's, you know, wrong with it, if anything. And I would use my new, questions. And the question I asked for the brakes, for instance, was someone somewhere knows that these brakes need work. So I tested like that, and I tested everything. And I told her, I said, the only thing wrong with the car are the brakes. What I was doing was testing the thought field of an owner, a repairman, somebody who knew, had seen the brakes, or the owner who'd known about the brakes. I was testing the thought field that was created when they thought about the brakes, saw the brakes, that they knew the brakes needed work. And it came up that someone somewhere did know that the brakes needed work. Who it was, I don't know. And so I waited, bated breath, and again, fortunately, she took the car to a mechanic, and we were talking. I said, oh, by the way, what about the car? What about the car? She said, everything's fine, except for the brakes. I was like, yes, it works. Suffice to say that quantum theory holds that nothing exists until it is observed. And and when it is observed, it creates a thought field. Now, David Hawkins says that in so many words, everything is observed by a conscious awareness he calls God. And so it is possible, therefore, to know anything about anything, anyone, everything, because there is a thought field there already created by God that should be accessible as a thought field with True Tester. I had a mole on my back. I knew nothing about it. It's an interesting story. I tested, I said, the mole's cancerous, the mole's not cancerous. I said, nope, not cancerous. I said, I tested, I should have it removed. Not have it removed. He said, yeah, you should have it removed. It's like, why? If it's not cancerous, why should I have it removed? And you know, guys, we only go to the doctor when we're basically on our deathbed. You know, you stay away from the doctor, you're fine. You go see the doctor and he always finds something wrong with you. At any rate, I went to the doctor and I had the mole removed. And a week or two later, we were talking and she said, oh, it's a good thing you had it removed. She said it was precancerous. I was like, oh. See, again, my conscious mind had no clue about something being precancerous. It's like, there's the reason why True Tester said to have it removed. It was precancerous. Not cancerous, but precancerous. So, you know, what an extraordinary thing. This thing could very well have saved my life. And again, the wonderful thing about it is I never would have gone up to a stranger or a friend or whatever and stick out your arm and let me test and test about this, that, and the other. You just feel sort of silly. I was at my dentist's. He was ranting and raving about something. I said, what's the matter? Said, they can't find my wife's $3,000 fur coat. I said, I'll find it for you in about 2 seconds. You know, the furrier says he doesn't have it. It's not at home. Can't find it. So I did a couple quick tests. Boom, boom, boom. It's here. It's there. It's at the furrier. I said, it's at the furrier's. He said, there's no way. He's adamant. He's looked everywhere. I said, okay. A couple minutes later, I was with my hygienist. I was getting my teeth cleaned. Having a small talk. How are you doing? Fine. She said, I'm pregnant. Oh, really? Do you know what you're going to have? She said, no, but I know it's a boy. My mother knows it's a boy. I know it's a boy. You know, how can you disagree with the mother? Mothers know these sorts of things. I said, do you want to find out for sure? She said, yeah, whatever. So I took out my True Tester and I said, nope, it's going to be a girl. It's a girl you have in there. She said, no way. Well, I called back my dentist a week or two later, probably to schedule whatever, I don't know. I said, did you find the coat? And he said, yeah, it was at the furrier's. I said, told you. He said, it was filed under my mother's name, same last name as my wife's. That that's where it was. How did you know that? How did you know that? That's incredible. My body knew the level of thought energy. And I was getting another cleaning. I said, Michelle, you know, you had the baby. What did you have? What did you have? He said, I had a girl. I said, I told you. She said, how did you know that? I'm the mother. I knew I was having a boy. So, again, that's one of the fun things about having this with you. Another thing that we've sort of touched on, but I think deserves a little further explanation, is the accuracy that you use when stating your questions in the form of statements. For instance, if you feel that a boyfriend or a girlfriend is cheating on you, and you say, Phil is a cheater, and you get a yes, you go, oh, I knew he was cheating. But it might be that Bill cheats on taxes. Maybe Bill cheat on a test. You have to be very, very accurate with your wording. If you say, you know, Bill cheats on tests, that might be a yes. If you're testing, if he's cheating on you, you have to say that. Bill is cheating on me. Or even more specifically, Bill, even if you say Bill is sleeping with Tanya, now if they're just sleeping together, doing nothing else, which would be a little odd, but if they were just sleeping together, that's what true tester would say yes to. If you want to go a little bit further, and rather being metaphorical about sleeping, if you want to get a little more specific, that is that you have to ask that precise question. So the subconscious mind is very literal. Once again, if you say Sally lies, you know, that girl says this, that girl says that, you know, Sally lies, you know, Sally doesn't lie, you know, well, you have to say Sally's lying about the fact that she didn't dent my car. You know, you have to be specific. Okay, another great thing True Tester is good for is testing for others. And right now, let's talk about testing for pets. I think it's a good idea personally to test your pet just every so often to make sure he or she is in good health. My beloved dog Bezor, unfortunately we missed her scheduled 6-month vet visit, and so she didn't get to the vet for about a year, and I noticed she was sensitive around her jaw, but I didn't think anything about it. In retrospect, it gives me, it's painful to think about, because when we got to the veterinarian, she said the Bezor had an abscessed tooth. And anyone who's had an abscessed tooth knows the excruciating pain that that causes. Animals are typically very stoic when it comes to pain. I think one of the reasons we love them so much is because they don't complain. They don't talk. They're typically just very happy to see you no matter what. And I would touch her jaw or something and she would sort of wince and so on. When I finally saw the tooth, I was, oh my God. If I'd had a true tester, I simply could have tested. Bezor is in perfectly good health, or she's not in perfectly good health. And if it would have come up that she was not in good health, then I would have proceeded to go through the various body parts and so on to see what was wrong with her. And in that way, prevent her from needlessly going through any more pain. But getting back to testing for others, I don't even really test for myself anymore. Someone asked me why, and I thought I'm not really sure why. But as I think about it, been using TrueTester now for 6-7 years. And initially, there was such a gap between my intuition and my conscious mind that each time I tested it and got confirmation, affirmation that my intuition was right, the gap closed and closed and closed more and more. So that now, if nothing else, I either have it or already know what's all I need to know. Just intuitively, I trust my intuition more. And I know things intuitively more now. I listen to my intuition more now. And I also just don't care. I think life is to be lived. And I want to hold on to that thought as I proceed to the idea of testing for others. I first invented my first TrueTester, which I'll go get, is this thing, little $12,000 TrueTester. I don't know if you can see this or not, but you test it once. And then you test it again, and when there's a differential between the two, there's a true and a false. I use this for everything. $12,000, you know. You can use it a lot. At any rate, I let everyone know about this thing. I've got, still do, lots of calls from lots of people about lots of things. Mostly questions about, does she like me? Does he like me? Did I do well on the interview? What do these people think about me? So on and so forth. One particular young man, I guess I still find this to be an interesting case. He was, what, 15, 16 maybe? And he was interested in a 13-year-old girl. And I guess I'm old enough to think that 13-year-old girls are 13-year-old girls, and they don't think about, you know, relationships and intimacy and that sort of stuff. At least they didn't in my day. We were all, you know, watching Dennis the Menace and decorating the Christmas tree. But his question was, you know, does she like me? Does she really like me? Does she want to get real close? And I already knew the answer. It's like, she's 13, man, you know, there's no way. So I tested, you know, Jane really likes Joe. And I got specific. Jane would like to do this with Joe. Jane would not like to do this with Joe. And I've done these tests for him, dozens of girls. They've always been right. At any rate, for this particular test that this 13-year-old Jane wanted to get very close, got a very high reading, a very very high differential. Here was like 1,080, well, 1,700 anyway, because you get like a reading of whatever that is, 652, then your second reading would be 434. That's a pretty high differential. So I'd say Jane really wants to get close with Bill. And then I'd say, Jane does not really want to get close with Bill. And I'd say, holy moly, the yes answer is like a 620 and the no is a 2-something. So I said, you know, I got to tell you, this thing is obviously wrong, because man, was I convinced that this just is impossible. I said, so the answer is wrong. Well, what is it? What is it? What is it? He says, yeah, man, she's like really, really interested in you. He said, you're kidding. That's great. It's like, no, it's not. She's 13, for crying out loud. Well, a week or so later, TrueTester was right. All of which is to say, TrueTester is wonderfully, interestingly, extremely effective for other people, and it's always a great affirmation for me, as it will be for you, to read for other people. Because the universal thought energy, once again, is universally available to our bodies. As our bodies process this universal energy by either going weak or staying strong. I did a reading for a girl. We're seeing a guy. It's another sort of incredible story. She said, you know, he says he's left his wife, they're divorced, and so on and so forth, and we've been going out, but I don't believe him. Okay. I think he's divorced, but I still think he's living with her. And again, I thought, why get divorced and still live with the person you've just divorced? It really made no sense to me. I mean, none. Once again, I did the reading. He's divorced. Yes. He's still living with his ex-wife. True Tester said, yes. And I said, once again, these are done over the phone. That's my phone. I said, True Tester is obviously wrong, finally, you know. And she said, why? What did it say? It says, yeah, it says he's still living with her, and it says he's still divorced. A week or so later, guess what? What? He's still living with her. He cannot afford to move out. And so, once again, bypassing my preconceived notions, my absolute firm belief that this couldn't be true, wasn't true. True Tester picked up on the fact that it was true. Yes, if you want, you can sit back in your bed and test anyone, anything you want. Instead of watching the news, you can get your True Tester and say, you know, Sally's over at Bill's, Sally likes Bill's, Sally, whatever you want. It's like turning on a TV to the infinite. I did a reading for a woman in Australia. She left a very obscure message. She said, I just want to make sure what I'm about to do is safe. And not only that, but the name was Donnie. And I didn't know if it was a male or a female I was talking to, so I tested, Donnie's a male, Donnie's a female. Well, Donnie's a female. I determined she was talking about a husband, not a boyfriend. I determined that he had severe mental issues. I determined that he was had a borderline personality disorder, that he was physically violent. A lot of these were yes and no answers. With the borderline personality disorder, I arrived at that, I could say partly by my own intuition, but as I read this guy, I would get a strong yes, then the same question, I get a strong no. I'd get equal readings. And I thought, this guy is. And I'd see, he'd come up that he was violent, then that he was not violent. Borderline personality disorder, these people are not fluctuating between normal and neurotic, but between neurotic and psychotic. I've known a few, and which may have helped. I also determined, in the diagnosis, I also determined that he had a drinking problem, severe, that he's alcoholic, that he abused other drugs. So, actually, against my own better judgment, I listed all these things, you know, boom, 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 and I sent it off, and I thought, oh, man, what did I do? I could have just said, you know, yes to this general question, or no, whatever it was. I thought, oh, man, you know, one of them, I'm just, like, totally wrong on everything. She wrote back immediately, you're incredible. Everything you said was true, is true. And, so the more you do this, just like me, the more you will start to bridge the gap between your intuition and your conscious mind. Right now, your conscious mind says it is impossible that that the rest of you could know this. It's though your body has a mind of its own, and it's not this one. I highly recommend reading for others, especially reading for your pets. If your pet is lost, you can go by directions. Sparky is north, south, east, west. How far away your cat or puppy is. Never use True Tester to as the sole source of information about anything. Use it to augment your knowledge, whether it's about a person or a pet. Oh yeah, almost forgot the favorite part. Alrighty. Typically, this procedure is done with the standard kinesiology procedure, where you stick out your arm. Well, you should all be familiar with it. You stick out your arm like this, and the other person presses down on your extended your wrist with using two fingers and presses down. So you stick out, the other person presses down as he goes through the various statements. Anyway, what you can do, just holding your True Tester, again using the invisible True Tester, put one hand on top of your head like that and squeeze True Tester as hard as you can. Or use your invisible True Tester. You'll get your strongest reading. Then flip your hand over and try it again, and you will be weaker. Observe. So I'll put my hand over my head. I'm using my electronic True Tester, and I'm going to slowly squeeze as hard as I can. Then I'm going to flip it over and slowly squeeze as hard as I can. Well, you got a differential up there. The strong squeeze was 7-something and the weak squeeze was 5. What you're doing when you have your hand over your head like this, the top of your head is a positive energy field. The bottom of your hand is a negative energy field. So you're making a strong positive-negative connection, just like you have two magnets with the similar poles. They will repel. You remember doing that in grade school. But then when you flip the magnets, the opposite poles attract. So what you have is a good strong attraction and a good strong force field. This is showing you how the body is electromagnetic. Another thing you can do, and I want to show this to the Steelers, because you can make anyone 15 to 20% weaker without even touching them. All you do is draw an invisible line down the front from head to, well, first we'll do the opposite. What you do is you draw a line up their torso. You're just, a few inches away from them. Draw the line up and you test. And you test right there. Maximum strength. Then you do the opposite. You draw the line several inches away, down, and you test your strength again. And you get a difference of, on this one, you get a difference of, there's 734 for the strong and 549 for the weak. You have reversed your energy field. So you want to reverse yourself again. So I was thinking the Pittsburgh Steelers, after each play, or any football team, I suppose, after the other guys get up, they should just sort of covertly go make the other team weaker, after every play. A psychologist friend of mine, one of his patients is a boxer. He showed the boxer this particular technique. So the boxer's boxing with the guy. He went to his opponent, and all that, boom! And the psychologist said, "So how did it happen?" He said, "The guy went down like a load of bricks." And well, my psychologist told the boxer, and told me, and I'm telling you, if you ever do that to somebody, be sure, just you're doing it in fun, and always make sure that you correct their energy back into the proper energetic formation. Also, if you're just feeling down for no reason and you don't feel like a beer, correct your energy flow. In addition to the thymus thump and so on, correct your energy flow back up to its normal configuration. or I'll come and, slap you on the wrist. Oh, I have all sorts of little things coming up. Certainly, there's just an endless number of topics that you can use TrueTester for. Marriage. Is it my greatest and highest good to marry Sally? It is not my greatest and highest good to marry Sally.
I even used it fishing.
You know, we were out fishing in the middle of the ocean, and we weren't catching a thing. And I took out my TrueTester just for the halibut. And I tested to see if there were fish north, east, southwest, and I believe it said they were, you know, off to the west. I said, let's go. I believe it was just like a mile. Let's go a mile to the west, see if we catch any fish. We caught fish. There's a whole school of them there. I thought that was a little strange, but it did work. You know, maybe we were accessing the thought fields of the sea bass. I don't know. Also, you know, there's all these pictures on the internet of aliens and crop circles and UFOs. Some are real, some are faked. You can use TrueTester to simply say these are photos of actual aliens, actual UFOs. You can go back in time and research historical questions about the pyramids. How old are the pyramids? How old is the Sphinx? According to Dr. David Hawkins, everybody's body will react the same way. It is like as though everyone in Seattle, if they turn the radio on to 98.9, whatever that might be, will get the same station. It's pretty much what he's saying, because everyone's body is going to pick up that same inviolate energy field, and it's either true, false, yes, no, and so on and so forth. When I read that and had just invented TrueTester, I thought, oh my God, this is going to be incredible. 5-6 years of testing, I discovered that personal biases can get in the way. It is not a procedure that is without, that is infallible. And I was surprised that Dr. Hawkins, someone as astute, erudite, and learned as he overlooked, bypassed, did not realize that this might be the case. 7 years later, in another book of his, he spends about a sentence or two saying, yes, indeed, it is possible that sometimes one's emotional state, expectations, and so on and so forth can indeed color your results. Which brings me to another point. TrueTester is meant to be nothing more than fun. When I started reading all this very heady, exciting, amazing stuff, I thought it's like the second coming of Christ. It's like, oh my God, I'm going to change the world. But then this would happen and that would happen. This would be right, that would be wrong. And it dawned on me, just like life itself, is just use it for fun. Doesn't mean that it can't work, that it might, maybe it'll diagnose cancer for you or pre-cancer and save your life. Maybe it'll do amazing things. Maybe you will earn tens of thousands of dollars like I did. That's fun. But use it in a lighthearted way. David gets very serious in so many words. He gets deeply spiritual, and which is fine, which is wonderful, and you very well may as well. Back to the point that I hoped I'd get back to. This young man with the 13-year-old still calls me all the time, and he's smart now. He'll have three or four girls he wants me to... wants to ask TrueTester about. He even has a true tester, but he finds it more fun to call and harass me, I guess. And he'll say, does Becky like me? Does Elizabeth like me? Does Cassandra like me? Young girls these days have the most amazing names. You know, Cassandra Riley and something something Kumar. And they sounds like he's dating all these movie stars. But anyway, I said, just date them. You know, call them up. Ask them. You know, life is to be lived. And that's one reason why I don't use True Tester for myself that much anymore. It's like, don't you want to find out if this? That's like, not really. Life is to be lived. Initially, it was a blast. And I still do use it. But maybe once a week. Very sparingly. But I do recommend that you don't overuse it. Certainly, I want you to use my invention. Because as you sort of sew together your intuition and your conscious mind, it is wonderful. It's one of the most exciting things that I think has ever happened to me. It's like, my God, my body does know this. It does know this. This is amazing. This is amazing. And all of a sudden, it no longer stops being, well, it does stop being so amazing. And you forget that there are 6 billion people in the world who do not have the ability that you do, because you have a true tester, to know things that it would otherwise be impossible to know. I've used it to find out if a store had something before I went there. I was looking for an electronic scale, because I was trying to save $12,000 making this thing. This is nothing more than a $12,000 miniature electronic scale. It's got some fancy microprocessors that do some fancy calculations, which I did get the patent for. But I wanted to know if the store had an electronic scale that you stand on, because I couldn't find any. And I tested this particular store. I said, yes, it does. I said, okay. And it went like the previous story with the book. I went there and couldn't find it. Help at register B, you know, we're looking for an electronic scale. And I was like, I don't know, it might be down that aisle. And they had one. And it'll be fun for you to also use it to see if someone's home before you go. Okay, let's go on to the True Tester game. I've included hundreds and hundreds, or a little over 100 questions, which can spawn hundreds and hundreds of more questions. I don't have anyone here to show you the True Tester game, how it's played with other actual live living people. But so you have Bill, Mary, and Sam, and me. You can either make a very innocuous statement like, Sam likes ketchup, or something like, if you want to be nasty about it, whatever, and embarrassing and mean, but which will do for the purposes of this exercise. We'll say, like, Sam would cheat on his girlfriend, we'll say, with, what's her name? Pamela Anderson. You know, I wouldn't, but you put that down there. You write that down. You write down 4 or 5 statements about the other players. So it's Judy's turn. Judy is next to you. She picks up any question she wants from the other piles, as long as it's not about her, and she reads this one about Sam. Sam, you know, would cheat on his wife or his girlfriend with Pamela Anderson. So, she has to bet whether or not this is going to be true when Sam tests it. So she'll say, Okay, he probably would. So she writes down, I'll bet 20 points. And if you, the other players can look at the question too, and they can also bet, would Sam do this? No. Would he do this? Yes. So, but the fun begins because Sam doesn't know the question. And so he gives him the true tester, and so he will access the thought energy of the question, and his body will react yes or no, using the body as a remote lie detector, reading these remote thoughts, just like I've done with the electronic scales and girlfriends and, moles and pets and everything else. So without knowing the question, without knowing he's nailing his coffin or exonerating himself, and everyone will be giggling and taunting and laughing, and the question might be, he likes ketchup. He doesn't know, so he can't cheat. And it's not like truth or dare, where you can say, no, I wouldn't cheat on my wife, or yes, I would. Because true test will not lie. So he's there any tests, and he's going to say, heaven help. what the question is, but it says, yeah, it's true. They go, and then they show them the question. You cheat on your wife with Pamela Anderson, or I played this at a bar a couple of weeks ago, and it was amazing. I the guy next to me, I said, it was sort of a convoluted version of the game, but I said something like, would you wear breast implants for a year, for $50,000. He goes, no way. I said, how about for $75,000? He goes, yeah, sure. It's amazing how just a rather small incremental difference made all the difference in the world to him. You could be 16 for the rest of your life and never grow old. And he's like, no, never do that. How about 21? Sure, 21 would be great. It's like, well, what's the difference? So it's very interesting. You find out interesting things about your fellow human beings. And so I've created all sorts of interesting questions. Girls, you find that some females would prefer to have like a perfect figure as opposed to having like 50 points higher in their IQ. It's like, yeah, whatever, I want to look good. Some girls want to be smarter rather than look good. It's just fun because, once again, the person being tested does not know the question. One of the questions is, if Sam saw a bum passed out on the street with his cup of money that he's begging for had fallen over, and there was a crumpled, say, $50 bill, a couple feet away from it. It's passed out, the cup's there, the bill's just lying there, it's 50 bucks. Would Bill put the money in the cup, or would he keep it for himself? If it's a $100 bill, it's $1,000. And you find out, what people would or would not do. It's interesting, sometimes they would say, sure, I'd put it back. And true test says, no, you wouldn't. And they think, well, yeah, I guess that's probably true. Or sometimes it says that, no, I'd keep it, man, I'd keep it. And true test says, no, you'd give it, put it back. And he goes, yeah, I probably would. So it's interesting, even when they consciously say they'd do self-centered thing, the true tester will access their more altruistic side. And sometimes when they say they're altruistic, true tester will expose their more selfish side. It's also a great tool for couples to get to know each other better, as long as you observe boundaries and speaking of borderline personality disorders, I was with someone on vacation, and we had this little gizmo here, and she would be, you know, and rather than enjoying the sunshine on the beach, she was like, you know, reading me. And after supposedly having this wonderful day, you know, this very expensive vacation in St. Kitts, you know, we'd come back and she'd be like, yes, dear. What seems to be the problem? And she was there reading, you know, Dusty's done this, Dusty's done that, and Dusty would do this, and you're probably going to do that to a certain extent. You're just going to, more than likely. So I can't say don't. I can't say I don't recommend it. I've done it. But if you're crazy, don't do it on vacation with the person paying for the vacation. Or at least if you do, try to have a sense of humor about it and assume that, you know, True Tester could very well be wrong. And, not that it ever is, but try to be good-natured about it, good-hearted, and use the power for good, Luke, you know? And if you become obsessive about it, if you find yourself going for whatever reason, whether it's greed or anger, any high emotion sort of sets you off. I had to do a reading on the woman in question. Boy, did she proceed to cook up quite a stew during and after this vacation. And it was difficult, but I had to put myself into a much more calm state of mind than I, it was difficult to put myself into a calm state of mind, but I would have to in order to get to read her properly and get to the bottom of what her particular problem was. And I also ended up using a friend to test. If you have a highly emotional issue, you can use a friend to test for you. Just have and you can think the question, the friend can say this is true. You can think the opposite, and the friend can say this is true. And your friend will be just as accurate, more accurate than you if you are highly emotionally biased, involved, upset, imbalanced about what it is you are investigating, inquiring. Oh, well, thank you. Good luck. Have fun. And send me your amazing stories. We're doing a book. We're doing a little more professionally put together video. We want to do infomercials and so on. And I'd love to have your testimonials and your amazing stories. So thank you once again, and talk to you soon. Give me a call or email.